be good. Mother. So, what are they? Eh?
What, 3 times, Brock? I boiled them.
Yeah, you boiled them 3 times.
Yeah?
Boiled them 3 times?
No. No. You did. I boiled them and I cut them.
Then you cut them?
Cut them into.
Oh, yeah, you boiled the squares, the circles boiled first.
The no, I boiled the potato whole.
Oh yeah, in the circles. Anyway, thanks for my dinner and stuff, Mum. Only a small batch, you could have told me.
Two half batches this time. The first one was the whole lot, weren't it?
Why don't you
shut up? You
can you put the rest of the bag in or what? Just put the rest of the bag of the chocolate chips in?
Yeah, on the top of that one.
Oh, it's nice, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh shit, they all fell off.
They all fall off.
That's what this is. Wet dog shit. Mmm. Oh, crunchy pieces.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It tastes nice.
I'll tell you what it is. I'm not too smart.
It's billionaire pieces, full size.
What's that?
It's like a mix of block, twiggy pieces in.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Demolished. There's a team at Mum. Oh, no John Stones. But yeah, my take on today's game is we've just come through some real tough games, but we just manage our way through the games most of the time. So a nice quick start gets us in the lead, and then we can just manage the game out. But we need an early goal. That's my take. Yes! Come on!
Get
him! Yes, Phil! So Everton have got an equaliser. It's 1-1. Luckiest, jammiest bollocks I've ever seen. Digne has a strike, hits the post, comes back off the post, and it hits Richarlison standing right next to the post. He knows nothing about it. It just hits him and goes in. 45 days since we've conceded from open play. That's ridiculous. Yeah. And that was that own goal that came off Ruben Dias. But we're in. Phil? Yeah, 45 days, that's mad. So, 1-1 at the break then, Mum. Yeah. Disappointing way to concede that equaliser, but...
Shit. You weren't disappointing, it was shit, that. Fucking shit, man. It fucking weren't even a fucking goal.
It was a goal.
It was a goal, but it weren't a fucking goal, was it? As it
yeah, it was. It goes in the net. It doesn't even have to go in the net, just has to cross the line. Oh, yes! Come on! Come on, Riyad! What a strike!
Fucking hell! Oh, God, that was
awesome! What a strike, Riyad! He loves a goal on Merseyside against the Blue Scouse. He loves it. Top, did he put it top bins off the post as well? My guy. Riyad Mahrez. Yes! Come on!
Get it, boys!
Bernardo!
Silva!
Run it down the wing. Make some Blue Room Boys sing. We're all gonna beat Everton 3-1. 76 minutes gone. One in Burnley. He's upset.
He really is.
Fernandinho. That's what you just did. 10 points clear. At the top. The machine rolls on.
What do you want, Mum?
Phil Foden got us underway. They got back into it, lucky as you like. But two bloody sweet as a nut strikes from Riyad Mahrez and Bernardo put us 3-1 to the good, and we take home the 3 points back to the Etihad from our trip to Goodison Park to play the Toffees. So yeah, brilliant stuff. We're 10 points clear at the top of the table now. Who would have thought that a month ago, just over a month ago, when we were still like just coming up the table before that game against Chelsea, like literally when this game got postponed, who would have thought that we'd have been where we are right now? It's mental. 17 in a row now, 17 wins in all competitions in a row. Bloody hell, check her out. And when you put, I know we've got a big squad in that, but we've got a lot of injuries going on. Mr. Gundogan's on the telly. Only joking, it's an ice cream man. He's nice ices. But people argue is what I'm saying. People will suggest it's because we've got a squad better than anybody else's that we're winning all these games in quick succession with this quick turnaround of games. But you got to remember, we've probably got like 4 or 5 players out. Important players. Mm-hmm. And then we keep picking up little bits here and there, which ends up ruling them out. Like Diaz wasn't available, and then Gundogan's not available today. Kevin Sergio ain't been available for ages. Mm-hmm. So for Pep to base, what I'm saying is for Pep to take on this run that we're on now. Like I say, all these quick turnarounds in games every 3 days is ridiculous. But to keep us playing consistent and consistently well, and then to achieve this 17-game win run that we're on now, unreal stuff. I'm basically saying it's surely got to be the most difficult. It's got to be one of the most difficult times to stay this consistently winning with how quickly you've, with the short distance between games, mm-hmm. credit that this run deserves is even more than normal.
Is his best ball on the squad there? Who?
Maybe. Oh, who's saying that? Performance
tonight.
No,
it was.
It was a good performance.
I think
they
played
good. So yeah, great performance today. We're looking ominous. We're looking scary. Scared, are you? Should be. But this has been a crazy season so far. It's been unpredictable. We are flying at the moment, but nothing. All good runs come to an end at some point. So it's all about the next game, which now is Arsenal at the weekend. The big game, and in that respect, the big games keep coming. But looking promising, looking ominous. But yeah, all that matters is the next game for now.